G'day Blackboarders. Have you ever wondered why some businesses seem to grow at an accelerated pace while others get stuck in a quagmire for years? Well, this week's episode, The 5 Phases of Business Growth, might help you understand and more importantly, help you see any transitions that you need to make in your business. Let's walk through the journey. We could start down here, a one-person business, maybe doing $100,000 in revenue a year. And for a lot of solopreneurs, that's the dream, that's the goal. They want to freelance or consult and make okay money. If you want to grow, if you want to get beyond that, you start to build a team and you head into the first phase, the doing phase. Now in the doing phase, you as the founder, the owner of the business, are ultimately responsible for doing everything. You know all of the clients, you probably did all of the sales, you know all of the projects that are going on, and you're responsible for the customer service, the HR, the marketing, and taking the bins out of an evening. That kind of works because you're on top of everything, but if you want the business to grow, eventually you need to transition. At about 12 people, 1.5 million in revenue, that transition goes from doing to process. As the business owner, you can no longer be on top of everything in the business. You've become a bottleneck. So you need to build and document the processes so your growing team can do the job you need them to do without depending on you. And a lot of business owners get stuck in trusting the team and documenting those processes. Now, even the processes will only get you so far. At about 35 people, and I stopped talking about dollars at this point because gross profit margins vary so much in different industries, but at about 35 people, you hit another transition point. The processes you've built, and probably you are the one who's built them, have capped out. You now need to recruit individuals who have specific capability to tell you how to run that part of your business better than you could possibly imagine. This is a great point for hiring a marketing manager, a HR manager, an operations manager. People who can come in and go, great, I see what you've done to get you here, but this is what we need to do to get you even further afield. And because they've got that capability, you can trust them to make more decisions, again, handing off some of your own responsibility. We keep going through the journey, start to get into a minority of businesses worldwide. At about 120 people, we go through the next transition. This is away from individual capability and into team strategy. At this point, you don't have a HR manager, you've got a HR team, each working together in their own specific areas and bringing strategy to you as the business owner. You don't know all the details of implementation. You don't understand how each of them do their job, but you don't need to. You just need to sign off on the strategy. And at the top level, north of 1,000 people, you start to get into a real corporate structure. This is where you need additional layers of management, communication channels, the kind of things that small businesses think of as incredibly boring and painful, but are necessary to actually keep a business of that size running. The key challenge for you as a business owner is being willing to let go at various points in time and for knowing where and how to let go of specific tasks. There are two key recruitment mistakes I see all the time. The first, in the transition from doing to process, is the lifesaver who becomes a martyr. At this point, one of your first hires was almost certainly some kind of office manager, someone responsible for a lot of the administrative functions, looking after the premises, the IT, the financials, maybe even helping out with some of the HR. Having that person who did all of that was incredibly valuable for you so you could focus on the revenue and growth. But at this point, that person is still holding on. They're not willing to let go, to hand off responsibilities. They don't want to document their processes. They've become a martyr. They've become an energy suck within the business. How did that happen? How did this person who used to be a godsend suddenly hold us back? And it's because the business has transitioned and that individual has not. Chances are you need to move that individual on. In episode 56, when I talked about the full R&R system, I talked about how 20% of your staff could leave. This is the kind of person who will leave, but it's better for them to go back to a business where their skills are valued and release the energy in your business. The other one I see all the time is a growing business that recruits somebody who has experience too far ahead. Back in the process phase, they get an opportunity to hire not just a marketing assistant or a marketing manager, but somebody who's run marketing for a 50 or 150 person business. And they think if they can do it for that, imagine what they can bring for our team. But the reality is they won't, they can't. At this point, you still need someone who can roll their sleeves up and get stuff done. Here, they're overseeing a team and the team are actually doing it. They've got the knowledge, but not the ability to actually do it. That's what your business needs. Recruit the right person for the right phase in your business.